Hello, I'm Li Zhou. I'm a visiting PhD student under the supervision of Dr. Valerie Benson at UCLAB, supported by the CIC project. Now, I'm going to present my eye movement study on attentional disengagement differences in young children with autism. As we know, visual orienting is a very important skill, which can help us acquire new information from our surroundings. Attentional disengagement is the first part of it, defined as disengaging attention from a focused item to look at a new target region. The current study aimed to explore visual disengagement from both static and dynamic geometric figures in young children with autism. Before that, basic oculomotor function was explored to ensure that any attentional differences were not because of challenges in basic eye movement in autistic children. In our first experiment, we adopted both traditional and modified tasks to explore disengagement across two groups of young children. Please see Figure 1 for the test procedures. In the first experiment, we found that children with autism showed intact basic oculomotor function, but they had delayed endogenous disengagement in our modified overlap task. As expected, we didn't find any group differences using the traditional gap overlap paradigm. We think this is mainly because the foveal stimuli have already been processed when the targets are presented in the traditional task. Followed by this, in our second experiment, we explored disengagement from dynamic stimuli across two groups of young children. In this study, we manipulated two types of foveal motion, the repetitive motion and the random motion. Please see Figure 4 for task procedures. We found that children with autism show longer scalar latencies from repetitive motion relative to the random motion, but this modulation effect was absent in the neurotypical group. In summary, we found delayed endogenous disengagement across both simple static and dynamic stimuli compared to neurotypical children using our modified overlap task. In addition, children with autism showed more delay when processing repetitive foveal motion than the random motion. But this modulation effect was not significant in the neurotypical group. These disengagement differences in autistic children may limit the opportunity to attend to and process more meaningful social information in their daily lives. Additionally, our current study unveiled the unique cognitive processing characteristics in young children with autism and provides an understanding of how this might impact the development of their social cognition.